Pi is, without a doubt, the most famous number in all of mathematics. From Archimedes' method of exhaustion, to Moschen-like formulae, to even the Chudnovsky algorithm, countless methods have been invented for the sole purpose of crunching out digits of pi. Venture on further, however, and you might stumble upon some more obscure and interesting methods. In this video, we'll be talking about an algorithm based on the famous Buffon's needle problem. The premise for Buffon's needle is pretty simple. First, we take a sheet of paper and draw a series of evenly spaced and parallel lines. On the left side here, we'll keep track of the total number of needles dropped, represented by n, and the number of needles that intersect a line, represented by m. A needle is then dropped onto the sheet of paper at a random position and at a random angle. For simplicity's sake, let's assume that the needle's length is equal to the space between the lines. Let's drop a few more needles so we can get a better sample size. Now, if we multiply the total number of needles by 2 and divide it by the number of needles that intersect a line, we should get a rough approximation of pi. And as the number of needles dropped approaches infinity, this rough approximation should converge exactly to pi. Admittedly, this method is pretty inefficient for computing pi. With our 500 needles, we barely scrape by with just 2 digits. But how does this even work in the first place? How could dropping needles on a sheet of paper give us pi?
Let's take a closer look at what is happening when we drop a needle. We'll define the distance between two lines as k, the length of the needle as l, and the smallest distance between the center of the needle and a line as d. Note that d cannot be greater than k over 2, since at most, the center of the needle will be in the middle of the two lines. We'll define theta to be the angle between the needle and the horizontal, and from this, we can find the needle's vertical extent from its center to be L sine theta over 2. Since theta's unique values can range from 0 to pi, we can graph the needle's vertical range as a function of theta. When the needle's vertical range exceeds the distance between the needle's center to the closest line, the needle intersects a line. Thus, everything underneath the curve is a scenario where the needle intersects a line. Now, to find the probability p of a given needle intersecting a line, we need to divide the desired area, the area of intersecting scenarios, by the total area, the area of all scenarios. The desired area is, as we said earlier, the area under the curve. Integrating L sine theta over 2 from 0 to pi gives us L. The total area is the area of all possibilities. Since d ranges from 0 to k over 2 and theta ranges from 0 to pi, the total area is k pi over 2. Substituting the 2 in gives us the formula for the probability, and rearranging the equation shows that pi equals 2l over kp. In our example, we set the length of the needle equal to the distance between the lines, which cancels out l and k, and leaves us with pi equals 2 over p. Since p is approximated by the number of intersections over the number of drops, substituting them into the equation will indeed give us an approximation for pi.